Welcome back to Let's Play A Tear of Vermillion Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Let's get some free food. Oh my! Are you Avin? Yes, I am. I was told this year's representative of Borun would be coming, so I was expecting a macho man. I'm surprised to see such a cute boy like you. Please don't call me cute. Oh, I'm sorry. Are you here for a meal? Today's special is fried river fish, fresh from Tabar River, shrimp, and black mushroom salad. It all sounds delicious, says Mile. We'll order two specials. Avin says, I'll cook them extra delicious for you, so wait for a while. Yeah, the shrimp and the fish sounds delicious. Avin says, the festival seemed to be much larger than I thought. There should be many people watching the match, too. I don't know if I can... Miles says, are you regretting you took the offer? Once you made a decision, you shouldn't look back. Well, Miles, you were the one pressuring him into it in the first place. You're enjoying this, aren't you? After all, it's not you who are fighting. Avin, I have always given you my sincerest advice for your best interest. Okay, okay. Don't look at me with such an awful look. But you're right. I am enjoying this. Hey! You should enjoy this, too. It is a good way to relax. You've been obsessed, Avin, ever since you talked to Sage Dunerkin. It's true our journey isn't only about fun, but that's all the more reason we should enjoy every small amount of fun we encounter along our way. We should enjoy beautiful scenery, delicious food, and meeting with people. You're right, Mile. I should make up my mind and do my best at the match. I accepted the job. I want to win at all cost. That's my boy. Avin says the water match is fighting without using any weapons. It is a lot different from sword fighting. Mile says your weapons are your power and speed. You are strong and you have quick footwork. I think you have a good balance of qualities required for this fight. Of course, we don't know who New Borun will send. What if they send Douglas? But if your opponent is a strong man of large build, you can move fast and get him tired. If the guy is quick, you just observe his moves and think of your strategy calmly. You can definitely win. Now that you analyze the possible situations, I feel I can win this. What's going on here? But I still need to practice for the match. Timings are different between wrestling and sword fighting. Someone else just ran up here. Mile says, I don't know what I can do, but I'll practice with you. A short boy. Okay, he's the one that ran up. Says, can I ask you something? Yeah? What is it? Says Mile. You are travelers, right? I have a question. Go ahead and shoot, says Avin. We are happy to help you. My name is Rouca. I'm from a town called Guia. It's north from here. We've heard of that one. Guia is a town of ironworks, says Mile. Yeah, I work at the factory. I'm still an apprentice, though. So what brought you here, young apprentice? Asks Avin. Actually, I'm looking for my elder sister. She's my only family. We were separated 3 years ago. Looking for your elder sister, says Avin. Avin? Rouca says, Oh, sorry. Why don't you sit down? Tell us the whole story. Okay, thank you. My sister's name is Rutice. Rutice? My parents were killed 5 years ago when our village was attacked by monsters. Since then, my sister and I have only had each other. We were always hungry and traveled from town to town. In Guia, we met people who were kind enough to take us in. But when I thought we would finally be happy, my sister disappeared, leaving me only a note. What did it say? Asked Mile. It just said, I want you to be happy. I see, says Avin. Who can accept that kind of goodbye? The factory gave me a long vacation, so I have been looking for clues about her. But I haven't been able to find anything so far. Mile says, tell us what your sister looks like. She is 16 this year. She has long, shiny, black, straight hair. Her eyes are also black, like polished volcanic glass. Mile says, black hair and black eyes. What color are Muse's eyes? Well, it can't be the princess. It was working in the factory. Miles says she should stand out in the crowd, just like Emel, who has red hair and green eyes. Emel? Says Rouca. It is my younger sister. We were separated after an incident 8 years ago. We're traveling in part to find her. So, I know how you feel, Rouca. You all also lost someone, says Rouca. Avin says, all right, we should help each other when in trouble. We'll help find information about your sister. I agree, says Mile. It's a good idea. Really? But this is my last day in Borun. I must return to the factory tomorrow. Mile says, then we should start looking right after we eat. Okay, says Avin. Excuse me, ma'am. Can we order one more special? Lunch lady chuckles, says, I've already cooked for three of you. I didn't mean to eavesdrop, but I heard you guys talking and started making another plate. Eat as much as you want and reserve your energy. It takes a lot out of you to look for someone. Thank you very much, says Rouca. Soon she brought plates full of food to the table. It was all fresh seafood from the Tebar River, such as river fish and shrimp. Avin, Mile, and Rouca cleared the plates in an instant, smacking their lips. Thank you, says Rouca. It was very delicious. I'm so full, says Avin. You're welcome, the lunch lady says. I'm glad you liked it. Okay, says Avin. We should get started. Miles says, I think it will be more efficient to ask people for information separately. Why don't we go our separate ways and meet back here at cafeteria later? Rouca says, okay, thank you for helping me. All right, says Avin, let's go. Miles left the party. Oh. Okay. I'm still gonna walk around and talk to everybody. Oh, what'd you find? Oh, crap. I wanted to talk to the cat. Good luck with your search. I will also ask my customers. Alright, so Rouca was already asking this guy, but let's ask him anyway. To bet on Borun or New Borun? That is the question. New Borun has picked strong players in the past, so I should probably... But I hear Borun hired a rookie adventurer this year. But then New Borun has a lot of drive, as seen in the heightened hunt for the Mipha. Still, New Borun is clearly a popular choice, so I have a better chance to win big if I bet on Borun. So the bottom line is, I have no idea which side to bet on. Well, we're wondering where this girl is. A girl with black hair and... Oh, a girl with black hair and black eyes? I may have seen her, but I'm not sure. I can't say for certain. Talk to the bartender last. I think I would remember if I'd seen a girl with such strange colored hair and eyes. I'm sorry, but I don't think I've seen her. No, I haven't seen her. I'm sorry. What happened? Avin says, we're helping him find someone. Have you seen a girl with black hair and black eyes? Well, I remember seeing a girl like that. Really? It was a short while ago. A girl with beautiful black hair came here with a man with pointy hair. When I told them the geography around the capital, they quickly left town. Well, I think those are the ones that knocked out Avin and Mile the first time. The Apostles. I think he's talking about the Apostles. They're from the underground world. I'd bet money on it. They had this evil air about them. A man with pointy hair and a girl with black hair, says Avin. I think I heard of that pair before. Anyway, she can't be Ruka's sister if she's from the underground world. You never know. But it was a strange pair. They weren't flirting with each other, so I don't think they were a couple. They might just be a couple who've been together for a while. Flirt with each other all the time. Well, the doctor's gone. Mayor Doyle informed me about you. What else is up here? Alright. So I don't suppose we can ask these people about... Nope. Let's just check up there. Because now we're actually supposed to go around and ask people things. Hey, what's up? I'm looking for someone. If I ask the guild to find her for me, I must pay you roses, right? That's the rule. That's how the Adventurer Guild works. You don't, maybe you have to go around the side of the counter to do it? Oh, never mind. He doesn't want to pay roses. I don't blame him. Festival is over, we'll help you find who you're looking for. Is that Rouca there? My cousin has black hair, but I don't think she's the one you're looking for. Are you looking for someone? Yes. Let's talk to Rouca, I think, last. Let's talk to these people. They don't have anything new to say. Girl with black hair and black eyes? I'm sorry, but I'm from New Borun. I haven't seen such a girl since I came here. Well, he's the one we have to ask him to. We traveled here from New Borun through the highway of two towns, but we didn't see anyone matching that description along the way. Sorry we couldn't help. Well, I don't think I've seen her before. Sorry, I don't feel like saying girl with black hair and black eyes every time. I'm sure you guys don't mind. Rouca, have you found anything? No, nothing. How about you, Avin? I haven't found any clues yet, but we shouldn't give up that easily. I will never give up. Avin, thank you very much. Avin says we should help each other when in trouble. Let's keep looking. Alright. We can pass through here. Alright. No thanks. Oh. No thanks again. Well, that's them. Ask the mayor yet. Oh, you keep finding a lot of things that I don't need. Oh, the mayor's not here. Who else are we supposed to ask? I'm missing. Oh my god, you're finding garbage very often. I can't jump on those. Well, we're just about out of people. Thank you. this walkway? Can we get on that? Oh, we didn't ask these people. I don't think we visit these people lately. Oh, this is the walkway. Oh, it goes in here. Never mind. Alright, so we've just need to ask these people. Miles says, "Hey Avin, have you found anything about Rouca's sister?" Well, not yet. No clues? Same here. We shouldn't give up, Avin. I said we shouldn't give up. "Hi there. I'm looking for someone," says Avin. "Have you seen a girl with black hair and black eyes?" "She sounds hot," says Willie. "I would like to meet her. So, where is she?" "I don't know. That's why I'm asking you if you've seen her." "If I had seen a girl with black hair and black eyes, I would be on a date with her right now, not standing here talking to you. I know I remember seeing a girl that looks like that." "You don't think black hair and black eyes, you can have any kind of shape of face, be, you know, freakish in looks just because you have black hair and black eyes. Doesn't guarantee any kind of attractiveness. Sorry." "I get back to work." "Hey, are you looking for someone too?" "As a matter of fact, yes. Do you have any information?" "I've already told that boy what I know. This is an unloading dock, so we seldom see girls around here." "Sorry, but I can't help you." "Well, we don't have anyone else to ask." "Yeah. No, I give up. I don't think there's anyone we haven't asked yet. Just look around for exclamation points. Oh, Douglas says, "How many times do I have to tell you? That's my master sword." Well, he's in the mayor's house. The mayor says, "We have finally found an appropriate prize for the match. We can't give it to you so easily." The mayor has his sword? "If you claim the sword is yours, show me proof." "I told you I don't have it. Ugh, this is going nowhere. I am leaving." Huh. Mile yells, "Avin!" I think that man was Douglas. "Yeah, I wanted to say hi, but he dashed out of town too quick. I wonder if he found his master's sword," says Mile. "By the way, how are you doing, Avin? Have you found any clues about Rouca's sister?" "Not really." "How about you, Mile?" "Same here. The only person I didn't speak to is the mayor. Have you asked him yet?" "No, because he wasn't in his house before." "No, not yet." Let's go and talk to him together. Welcome back to the party, Mile. Hi there. Are you seeing the sights in town? We have a question for you, says Mile. Have you seen a girl with black hair and black eyes, around 16 years old? As far as I know, there are no girls matching that description in this town. Is she your friend? Avin says no, she's the sister of our friend. So she doesn't live in Borun. I have another question. Do you have a girl with red hair and green eyes living here? No, I don't know her either. I'm sorry I couldn't help. Don't be, that's alright. Mile, we should head back to the cafeteria. Rouca is going to be disappointed. Yeah, let's go back. By the way, Mile says, the customer you were talking to just now, what did he want? Oh, that adventurer? Well, it was nothing. Avin says, but you were having a heated argument. He was mistaken about something. He didn't argue too much, and then he left. As a matter of fact, it involved you, Avin. Me? How? I'm sorry, I can't tell you right now. I'll tell you after you win the match. Okay, so the winner gets that sword, obviously, that Douglas is looking for. The Thunder Sword. Good luck in the water match. Alright, we're going back to the cafeteria. Red bandana and a blue uniform. Are you a player for Borun? Well, something like that. It's my lucky day. I can't believe I am meeting you. Hey, old man. Mile says, let him admire you, Avin. What have you go to lose? Yeah, but... Anyone else have new stuff to say? Is the kid with blue hair your friend? He's waiting for you at a table in the cafeteria. Oh, should we see if other people have new stuff to say? Well, the festival is drawing near. I should probably call it a day. I can't wait to see the water match. I hear New Borun is frantically looking for someone who can represent them in the water match. We're sending an adventurer, so New Borun is making desperate efforts to find a person of comparable skills. Gee, the festival is going to be fun. Well, who told them that they're having an adventurer compete? Loose lips sink ships, after all. What? Douglas came back and left again? Oh no. Chitta was longing to see him. But Chitta doesn't say anything new. The festival is entertaining and I love it a lot, but it costs money to have fun. Yeah, we've read that before. I read that before. New Borun hasn't decided on their representative yet, but Mayor LeBrand wants to hire an adventurer. I hear Borun is also sending an adventurer, so I guess it'll be an exciting match. I guess so. Have you found Ruka's sister? You do not deserve an answer. I feel sorry for the blue-haired guy. He can't find his sister. The young man with blue hair went to the inn. Thank you. They never have anything new to say. The festival is approaching, and the town is filled with excitement. I have to work, so I can't go to the water match, but I'm certain you will put up a good fight. At this point, all you need is to keep yourself in good condition so that you can demonstrate all your strength at the match. Anyway, I wish you luck. Alright, I think we talked to everybody. Does this guy have anything new to say? I decided. I'll bet on Borun for the water match. No, wait. New Borun is also looking for an adventure to represent their town. But then again, the representative Borun pulled off a great feat in Filden that even impressed the king's army. Oh, I don't know what to do. Very wishy-washy person. Have you found any encouraging information? If you do, you should tell him quickly. Nope. Nothing encouraging. Avin, Mile. Mile says, how did it go? Have you found any clues about your sister? No. The bartender at a tavern saw a girl who looked like my sister. He said that the girl left for the capital. We met the mayor, says Avin. I don't think your sister lives in Borun. I see. I was too optimistic. How can we find her so quickly after all this time? Don't be disappointed, says Mile. I'm not. I won't give up. Rutice is important to me. She's my only family. I'll visit the capital during my next vacation. That's the spirit, says Avin. I should be heading back to Guia. Thank you so much for everything. By the way, I heard in town, Avin, you'll be fighting in the water match. Well, it just got decided today. It's too bad I have to leave. I wanted to see you fight. But I'll be cheering you on from afar. Good luck. Thanks. I'll do my best. Oh yes, Guia is a big town. Someone may know something about Imel. I'll ask around, so please visit me when you come to Guia. Thank you. We'll certainly drop by. Miles says, travel safely on your way back to Guia. I will. You take care too. Bye! Miles says, I hope you find your sister soon! I hope so too! For the next 3 days, Avin and Miles spent most of their time practicing for the wrestling match. I thought it was a water match. When Avin finally got the hang of it, it was already the opening day of the Eden Festival. What's a wrestling match in water? I mean, I don't even know what it involves. All I know is that there's no weapons, which makes sense for wrestling. MC, our next program is the singing and dancing by the children of Borun. Please give them a big hand. Clap, clap, clap. Take it away, kids. Clapping. We're going to sing Spring Breezes. Please listen. Your audience is clapping. Turn and twirl in the spring breezes. Yeah, I'm not singing. Dance under flower petals. Sing with the birds. Well, I'm nervous, says Avin. Don't worry, you practice so much. As I said, if the opponent is stronger, move quickly to get him tired. If he is quick, observe his moves closely and take time to attack. I have a feeling that whoever this opponent is going to be somebody we've already met. Yeah, I know. I'll win by all means. Committee member says, Avin, are you ready? Yes, I'm ready to go. All right, please come up to the stage. The representative of New Borun is already there. Ladies and gentlemen, our next program is the water match. The audience is cheering. Hey, says Avin. Look over there, says Mile. I knew it. They recognize him. I knew it was Douglas. Mayor says, we're counting on you, Douglas. I know. I'll do my best. Well, whoever wins... Hey, Avin and Mile. I didn't know you were still in Borun, says Douglas. So if we win, we'll give Douglas the sword. If Douglas wins, Douglas will get the sword. Win-win. Even if lose. Avin says, Douglas, what are you doing here? What happened to your master's sword? It's a long story. Anyway, I'm fighting in the water match. What? Miles says, are you the representative of New Borun? Yep, that's me. By the way, the representative Borun is late. He probably got scared when he found out that I was his opponent. No, he's right there. I'm sure he didn't get scared, says Avin. Hey, Mile. How can I fight with a person who has both power and speed? Ha ha ha. Well, Douglas, the representative Borun, is Avin. Huh? The MC says, let's call the representatives of Borun and New Borun forward. Please give them a big hand. You can do it! Clapping. Is this a joke? Says Douglas. That's what I was going to say, Avin says. Douglas says, anyway, we have no choice but fight. Avin, I'm sorry, but I must fight in earnest. Oh, how can I fight against him? Miles says, certainly Douglas is stronger and faster. But as they say, anything can happen. Thank you for those encouraging words. You've practiced really hard. Don't give up, and a chance will become available. When did he practice? Just be strong and do your best. Let me introduce the contenders representing New Borun, Douglas. Shouldn't he call him Lightning Douglas? Bring it on, says Douglas. The women's screaming, he looks so strong. Representing Borun, Avin. The woman screaming, he's so cute. Oh, brother. Before we begin, let me reiterate the rules. The contenders can't use any weapons. No biting, pinching, or titty twisting. What? And no hitting below the belt. Other than that, they are free to do anything like punching, kicking, and throwing. There is not time limit. The match ends with either contender falls into the water. Do you have any questions? I'm fine, says Douglas. Got it, says Avin. Now I'm getting off the stage. The match will begin when the ramp connecting the stage is removed. Fight! Well, not exactly yet, but... Now fight.